Yes. Hello all. We missed today's live session. So I'm recording this in order that you will not lose the content as such. So this is going to be a very, shorter than the usual 1 hour lecture, around 40 minutes, which I'm going to provide you through YouTube, wherein you can watch the lecture and you can comment your roll number as a mark of you have watched the lecture. The lecture will be divided into two or three parts. So all the three or four parts you need to watch and as well as comment on that. Any place you feel like you are not understanding something, you can use the comments box of YouTube for asking the query there, which I will be very appreciable by me. Okay, now we were discussing last lecture about planning problem. And today I'm going to talk more about planning problem. Just to put things into perspective, we saw that planning problems are the problems which are generally very much similar to the state space search problems. Only the difference between planning and state space problem is that the representation of planning problem is different from state space search, and the problems that the planning problems can solve might be more complex and more larger and real than the state space search can solve. Okay, and this property of planning problem is because of the representation that the planning problem use. So in planning problems, for the representation of the problem, we use not only the state space search kind of representation, where we had represented the goal state, goal test, initial state, successor function, and set of valid actions. So these were the things that we use for representing a state space problem. For representing the problem in planning problem, we use some more detailed representations, which are represented using the logical representation language or the knowledge representation language, like predicate logic or propositional logic. So the states are represented using predicate or propositional logic clauses. And the clauses that we use are generally the ground clauses, which are not having functions inside them. So this is a stripped down version of first order logic. Okay, which will make it very much look like your propositional logic, but will have or will retain the predicate facility, which is not there in propositional logic. So functions are not there in the representation of states in case of planning problem. So we saw that when we represent planning problems, three things we discussed yesterday. One thing is how we represent states. Second thing is how we represent goals. And the third thing is how we represent actions. The representation of actions are also referred to as action schema, or the way of representing an action in normal common English. The goal representation can also be referred to as or termed as goal satisfaction. The concept of goal satisfaction comes into picture when we try to represent the goal. And the representation of the state is very, very much necessary in any sort of problem which can be solved as a state space search. So we will be applying or trying to apply state space search solutions, the algorithms that solve state space search problems. But while doing so, the representation of the problem, we are changing it to have the knowledge component using the logical representation of states. Okay, now we also saw yesterday that we may have positive literals connected together as conjunctions in the representation of states. So one example over here is poor and unknown. So poor is a positive literal and unknown is another positive literal, and we are intersecting these two to have a state of a person's mind who is very hapless state currently, poor as well as unknown. Similarly, we can also have, if we want to use predicate logic, and we are talking about traveling from one airport to the other airport, and we are talking about a domain of airplane travel. This particular state, which represents at plane 1, comma Melbourne, and at plane 2, comma Sydney, actually captures a state of this particular air traveling problem or cargo transportation problem, which says that plane 1 is at Melbourne and plane 2 is at Sydney. So this is how we represent states. So states are nothing but an conjunction of individual assertions, and these individual assertions either are ground terms or they are function free. The literals such as at xy, wherein x and y are representing variable terms in the predicate, and at father of Fred, comma Sydney, these kind of representations are avoided to be used in the planning problems. In planning problem, to represent a state, we use the ground terms in place of all the parameters of predicates that I use in the definition of state. Also, I avoid using any functional representation as a parameter of a predicate. The other important fact that we need to remember always when we are trying to represent state in a planning problem is that the state in the planning problem should be constructed such that we retain the property of closed world assumption. Now, what is closed world assumption? It means that any condition, so and we are actually anding two things, means we are actually saying that this as well as this condition holds. So two assertions are anded means both the assertions hold. This is what it means. So any condition, so at such time, whenever I'm saying something is hold, in programming sense, we are actually making certain conditions or certain rules that these things are true, something like that. So the meaning here is that any conditions that are not mentioned in the state are assumed false. So closed world assumption means any of the conditions which are not mentioned in the representation of state is assumed to be false. So for sake of example, say suppose I have three characteristics of a person. One is he is poor. Second is he is poor or rich. He is known or unknown. And third is he is educated or he is not educated or uneducated. So educated, uneducated. So whenever I want to represent a person as a poor and unknown, as I'm representing over there, and I've not mentioned educated as the third clause of that particular condition or the state, then it means that automatically person is uneducated. That is, the educated literal is false. This is what closed world assumption means. Okay, so representation of states are done like this in this all discussion that we are doing. So if you remember yesterday, we said that we are going to look at this particular representation of planning problem, which is referred to as STRIPS. PS stands for problem solver, and STRI stands for Stanford Research Institute. So Stanford Research Institute problem solver uses this way of representation of states. There is another representation that book discusses, but your syllabus does not. It's called as ADL, but it is worthy to understand how STRIPS is different from ADL, and we'll come to that point today. Second thing that we already discussed was related to representation of goals. So whenever we are representing goals, goals are nothing but they are partially specified state. Means in the goal, some of the clauses or some of the literals which are present in the state will be available, and not all are necessary. So I may have a goal called as rich and famous, okay, or I may have a goal as at P2 Tahiti, if Tahiti is the place where I want to be with plane number 2. Okay, the propositional state S satisfies also. And now the other important definition that you need to understand is this one, which is called as goal satisfaction. So whenever we have a goal in this form, where the goal is representing some partially specified state of the world, then we can define satisfaction of the goal as a propositional state S satisfies a goal G if S contains all the atoms in G. So atoms are the literals, all the literals in G. For example, the state rich and famous and miserable satisfies the goal rich and famous, because rich and famous here are nothing but the atoms part of this particular goal, which are also part of the world state, which is rich, famous and miserable. We are considering that S is rich and famous and miserable, and G is rich and famous. So rich and famous, these atoms are present in my state, and hence I can consider that goal can be satisfied with the current state. And you can also understand here why we said that goal is a partially specified state. What if I did not have famous and instead of I had unknown here, rich and unknown? Now we can say that the rich part is satisfied, but unknown part is not satisfied with the state. So then the state is not satisfying the goal. Now this could act somehow as a goal test for us in the problem solver that we will be designing later. Okay, now going ahead, this is the point where we had stopped yesterday, representations of actions. Now, as we know that only defining the states, only defining the goal and the goal test isn't enough. We want the sequence of actions that we that will take us from the current state or the initial state to the goal state. And if we do not define the transitional behavior of the problem, this is not possible. So actions are responsible for defining the transitional behavior of the problem. So we need to understand how we represent actions in STRIPS representation, or Stanford Research Institute problem solver representation of planning problem. An action is specified in terms of preconditions that must be held before it can be executed, and the effects that ensues or that gets created or generated when the action is executed. So whenever an action happens, what actually happens is the state of the system or the state of the world changes, or state of the environment changes. Now there will be some state before the action can actually take place, and that particular state is referred to as the precondition. So once we match a precondition, then we can apply a particular action, and not all action are possible in every state. So this is something like how we find the valid states or valid actions out of the all possible actions in a problem solving agent. So preconditions again will be some sort of a representation of a state, which may be some augmentation of a state. So whenever I say augmentation, it could be having more atoms than the state, or it may have partial atoms than the state. Just like goal, we said, was having partial atoms than the state. Fine. Going ahead, once the preconditions are met, we can consider that we can apply the action. And once the action gets into act, the state of the environment changes, and this will generate some sort of effects. And these effects would mean maybe certain atoms are removed from the state because they are no more assertions or assertive, and certain atoms can be added to the set of atoms or set of atoms that represent the state because they are now assertive or positive. Now we are considering this particular action. So this is the definition of action. So the one that I'm highlighting now. So the word action tells us that this is the action. This bracket starts over here and ends at this particular line number 3. So name of the action is what I first specify. The name of the action is fly. Okay. It has 3 parameters, P, from, and 2. And these are variables, by the way. So the actions in a STRIPS representation may have variables. State does not have variables. Preconditions, effects,